Yes, greetings, family. Greetings once again. I have a powerful message for you today. The secret to your success. The secret to your success. Relax, chill out for a moment, and let me take you on a journey. The secret why and how one group of people are more successful than other groups, and the secret reason you may not be as successful as you like. The recipe for success. When it comes to success, here's the formula. Success is the personal commitment you make to yourself. First, you need to have the desire, the dedication, and determination in order to generate the staying power needed to acquire this elusive goal called success. What is staying power? It is your ability to remain focused and stay the course no matter the obstacles. Attitude adjustment. Just keep in mind that no matter what you decide to do in life, time will pass by. So practice excellence as a way of life without having to have someone hovering over you and constantly telling you and reminding you what you need to do. This should come from yourself, right? Staying power is your ability to finish what you started and the mental fortitude, toughness to hang in there when things get tough. This desire becomes your motivation, and then the fire of inspiration will ignite in you, inspired enough to become self-motivated, a self-starter, which means no one has to encourage you to do what is required to excel in your endeavors. You will be dedicated to your purpose and determined through your actions to reach your required objective. Your self-determination will separate you from the crowd. You will become your own inspiration, and you will become an inspiration to others. When you decide to improve yourself, this new power of inspiration will allow you to improve your income-generating potential as well by sharing your inspiration with others who will be captivated by your renewed outlook on life. Organize yourself, family and friends, using my free estate planning legacy calendar found on my website below. It will immediately begin training you in the creation, accumulation, and preservation of wealth. This is an urgent matter and a necessity within our homes and communities, the 98%. One of the biggest things I teach is that for you to succeed, you need to develop a why and how. A plan of action. This is your roadmap to whatever you're doing, whatever you're going to do in your life. What is purpose? A plan which will direct you to your purpose. Your purpose is what drives you to your destination. Your purpose is your emotional fuel. Your emotional fuel is activated by the amount of your desire, dedication, and determination you are willing to commit to reach your desired objectives. These objectives are the goals you set for yourself as you work towards your life purpose. In college, I changed my major at least 3 times, but I kept moving forward towards obtaining my college degree. I didn't quit. I just altered my chosen objective. Most people relate success with having a lot of money or what they see on television or what they see others accomplish. For you to have a lot of money, you need to have a purpose for your existence and surround yourself with a team of others who share the same vision. What is the difference between a street hustler and a businessman? The street hustler only cares about the transaction, while the businessman cares about repeat business and customer relations. Success is generated from your goals, which is aligned with the action plan for your life. Your success and or purpose in life can be good or can be bad, but the formula is the same. So we can boil it down to this simple equation. Success equals preparation and purpose. Then you will be in a position to get lucky. Luck is defined as when preparation meets opportunity. I've heard a legendary artist say, after struggling and perfecting their crafts for decades and eventually opportunity knocks because they were prepared for the occasion. They said, I was a 15-year overnight success. a 15-year overnight success. Important point. No matter what you decide to do with your life, remember, there is a judgment day. So choose wisely. The truth is that most people do not have a lot of money because they don't have a plan or strategy for their life, which means they don't have a sufficient amount of desire, dedication, and determination in their spirit to achieve results. This simply means they don't believe in themselves enough to invest in themselves. Low self-esteem and no focus. You must believe in yourself first. Your energy, effort, and enthusiasm for success must be strong enough to motivate you to take action in your own life and stop you from being starstruck, which is the act of vicariously living your life through others, constantly judging others without any positive action taken in your own part. You know people like that. Some call it being a loser, a hater, the crab in the barrel syndrome, or just trying to keep up with the Joneses without direction, focus, or action in their own life. The poor in spirit who refuse to become inspired for their own sake is representative of a generational curse being passed from one generation to the next. Inspiration is created from a person's inner power, which is lacking in most instances because poor-spirited people lack self-esteem and have, by their own device, trickery or deceit, given their power away to third parties. A pimp lesson for another day. Most people are not successful because they do not have a big and important enough reason to do so. Combined with inadequate thinking, poor education, engaging in inappropriate financial behavior, and most important, a lack of formal guidance and development. Simply put, personal success is just not that important to them. A person's environment and encouragement at a very young age is extremely important, which can add to the development of an individual's level of self-esteem and the way they view themselves in the world. It is important to start this developmental process at a very young age, before adults' life starts to get their attention, before they possess competent skills for their success. Life is difficult because life is a business. For example, if playing around, fooling around, being unproductive is more important, if your priority in life is to watch television all day, talk on the phone, play video games, engaging in activity which will not move you forward in life towards your goals, and you never ask yourself why, you're not successful. Keep in mind that success means different things to different people. Success doesn't necessarily mean that you have a $1 million home or even have $1 million in investments or cash flow or even a $1 million line of credit. Sometimes success to some is merely the ability to function in life, like raising your children so they can become productive citizens, or you being able to pay your bills on time, able to satisfy the basic necessities of life such as food, clothing, shelter, transportation, and medical care. And if you're not living on the streets in times such as this, you should consider yourself a success. However, this is the ground floor in life, and most people want to move up the economic ladder. Listen, and understand there are at least two paths in life, and each path you choose will produce different results. I'm not saying one path is better than the other, but one is going to take priority over the other. If your priority is asking the question why, you should eventually begin to commit more time to the why. If your priority is something else, like partying and wasting precious years that you'll never get back, then you'll do that. Quite simply, you always know what's important to you by the actions you take or don't take. If you want to know what's important to you, just watch yourself, and very quickly you'll know. Your actions will shout loud and clear what you really want. The seeds you sow in life will produce your harvest. No seeds planted, no harvest. No ticky, no laundry. For a lot of people, fooling around, being unproductive, watching television all day, drinking beer, and being constantly turned up and ready to party, and if that's your priority, I must say I have no problem with it because it is, of course, your life. However, please understand a life of moderation is the best course of action. I have a saying, work first, play later. Look into the mirror and then stare deep into your soul and ask yourself, what are your priorities? Remember, whatever you decide, you will be making a conscious decision which will shape your destiny and define your future outcome. When it comes down to it, you need to ask yourself, what's your why and how for success? Why do you want the success, and how do you plan to achieve it? Well, if you ever hear yourself constantly saying, I can't pay my rent, chances are you need to make a serious change in your life in order to change the outcome. Chances are you're going to make the money, but if you put your mind to it, and especially if you have the opportunity and the skills necessary to produce the desired outcome. However, in most lives, there is a fundamental problem when you are living from paycheck to paycheck each month, living a random life without a plan, and always complaining about what you need and don't have, while doing absolutely nothing to bring about any results. For example, if you really, really need to pay your rent on time, need a new car, or you really need to make $45,000 extra this year, you must start looking at different opportunities and doing things differently in order to rebuild your whole life. And guess what? You're most likely going to make it happen if you have a dedicated action plan that is in line with your stated objectives. If changing past unproductive behavior is not that important to you, chances are you will find the necessary excuses and easily find something else that's more important, and you'll put your energy, effort, and enthusiasm elsewhere. Simple as that. Steve Jobs once said, my intention is to make sure there's a computer on every desk in the world. And you know what? He did a hell of a good job getting there because he set that intention in motion after he became qualified and skilled. He was able to realize his dream, purpose. That's your why. Why do you want to succeed? What do you want in your life? What is it that's important to you? What's your how? How is it to be accomplished? And again, is it important enough to make it happen? Are you willing to be a warrior for your success? A true warrior always has a purpose for going into battle, and that purpose is always self-fulfilling. The warrior's purpose could be for personal satisfaction, for their family, for their legacy, for their culture, or for their country. The truly successful always has a bigger purpose than just for themselves. A true warrior is also skilled in battle, ready and equipped to meet the challenges ahead. So if success is really important to you, you can rest assured you'll do it when you discover your bigger purpose and prepare yourself like a warrior for the task ahead. If success is really important to you, ask yourself, have you established an action plan which will become the why and how in your strategy to move towards your purpose? The stronger your desire, dedication, and determination, the easier success becomes. If success is important to you, then you will create an action plan for yourself in order to become inspired, having a strong desire to succeed in your studies and training so it can be activated in your life. It is the amount of your energy, effort, and enthusiasm combined with your desire, dedication, and determination that you are willing to commit to your personal growth and professional development, which you can harness and then channel into your everyday life. Success does not come from charity, but from your own energy, effort, and enthusiasm you put into your own personal growth and professional development, which requires investing a portion of your time, talents, and treasures into your own building fund called self. It is, after all, your decision to make. But ask yourself the why and how of becoming successful. If it is important enough for you to discover your purpose and live that life of prosperity you constantly imagine. Listen to what Jerome had to say about finding his way, his why, which is exactly what this movement is all about. Jerome says, my why is to have billions of people worldwide connected to a social experience that allows them to become who they are with no regrets. My family, friends, and loved ones, lives will be changed forever because my why is extremely powerful because it will allow others to shine, not just me. The power is in no man because the power is within all of us, the people. This is the why, but what remains is the how. Boardwalk School of Economics was created for such a time as this. Boardwalk School of Economics is your how. This is your call to action. Will you come and join me in helping yourself and then others to evolve in the spirit of success? As a member of the Temple of Inner Peace and Prosperity, this is my 21st century ministry, my call to action. This is your baptism and the renewing of your mind. The scripture gives us the answer. The universal power of unity tells us where two or more minds are gathered together in the spirit of unity, the power of the great I Am is in the midst. This is a universal law, and hopefully you will use this secret power for God's glory and for good, because this universal law is not a respecter of persons, which means this law is a universal rule and does not show favorites of persons if you operate within this simple law. This is why rulers of this world will first divide and then are able to conquer. Now, the money question. What is the secret riddle to success? First, what is a riddle? A question. It is a question or statement requiring thought to answer or understand. A conundrum, such as, how can a black man be 3/4 of a man? A historical statement that is perplexing. An enigma. An enigma is a statement that is puzzling, ambiguous, perplexing, or inexplicable. A black man is 3/4 of a man, which only means unity will make you more than a whole part. Why was slavery abolished? Because of unity of the people. The scripture also tells us that my people perish for their lack of knowledge, which also covers the system of things. The law of unity is the law of God. This is why they passed Jim Crow laws to keep the slave divided and frightened, and over time it will become self-fulfilling. Think about this. Where there is no unity, there can be no mentorship, which leads to unnecessary poverty, isolation, and despair. One, help discovering your why and how. Join the movement and enroll in Boardwalk School of Economics. Share and like this video and see both websites listed below on the screen. When you log on the website, see the Rite of Passage program and download your free estate planning legacy calendar. And please leave comments below. Thank you. May God be with you and bless you.